What tests should be used for testing protein status?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Ekaterina Ptitsina says, hello, Chris. What is your approach for evaluating protein status in the body? Do you consider serum protein, such as albumin, as a reliable indicator of protein sufficiency, or amino acids profile would better indicate the protein status? How should we assess it if we absorb all the consumed protein? Thanks a lot in advance. I highly appreciate your work. It's possible that your albumin will be low if you're not consuming enough protein, but the amount of protein deficiency you'd have to have for your albumin to be low is more severe than the amount of protein deficiency that you would need to lose out on important support for your lean body mass and for your metabolic health. So I wouldn't use blood markers for protein status at all. I would mainly rely on dietary intake. I'm sure there's variation in protein needs, but not to the point where it's necessary to use blood markers rather than just trying to be in the range that is enough for most people. And so generally speaking, if you measure your weight in pounds, then you want a half a gram to a gram of non-collagen protein per pound of body weight. If you're overweight or underweight, you can use your target body weight, meaning what would be a healthy body weight to have or what are you trying to achieve. And if you measure in kilograms, then 1 to 2 grams per kilogram. I'm aware that that calculation doesn't perfectly add up, but I think it's just easier to round to whole numbers or to like half numbers, half integers. Those numbers are mostly the same. Amino acid tests. That's really about looking at whether you have metabolic problems. There's no reason that you would need to look at the amino acid, free amino acid values in your blood to try to as opposed to total protein levels in your blood, as an index of your protein status. The reason you would look at plasma amino acids would be to see if certain plasma amino acids are elevated or are low relative to others that indicate something specific about your metabolism. So there's, amino acids undergo lots of different conversions, both between each other and into valuable things and into things that help you get rid of excess protein. And so if certain specific amino acids are high or low, you can make inferences about what metabolic pathways are disrupted. But that has nothing at all to do with total protein status. Now, with that said, sometimes if all the amino acids are all low, that is consistent with not eating enough protein. But you don't have to go that far to find that. In terms of not absorbing the protein, you probably want to look at a fecal protein test if you're worried about that. So, let's see. Let's see if there's a good, not sure if some of the, I'm trying to see if some of the major functional medicine stool tests have protein. All right, so the GI effects doesn't have it. Let's see if maybe LabCorp or Quest have it. Yeah, so I'm actually not even sure how to get total protein in stool. I don't know if anyone offers it. But that's what you would want to see if you weren't absorbing the protein. Let's see. Just checking LabCorp real quick. Doesn't look like they have it either. Everyone's got fecal fat. No one's got fecal protein. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, generally speaking, I think if you are malabsorbing protein, you're probably malabsorbing other things. And so you would probably look at that more from a GI perspective based on the GI symptoms and the GI labs rather than making that inference from blood levels of protein. But I guess that, you know, if you weren't sure whether there's a GI issue and you're eating enough protein and your total protein is low, your albumin is low, and you happen to have run an amino acids test for some other purpose, and most of the amino acids are low, then I think you could use that as evidence that you might not be absorbing enough protein. But the first and foremost way of determining it, you know, whether you're getting enough is your diet. So if your dietary analysis says you're getting enough or more than enough, and you have reason to think you might have malabsorption, but you're not sure, and your total protein, albumin, and if you happen to get it for some other reason, your plasma amino acids are across the board all low, then I do think that would be a potential indicator that you are malabsorbing the protein. All right. Hope that helps, Ekaterina. Thank you for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.